child frolicked in the fields outside his house every day, but his parents always warned him to stay away from the bay, though he never knew the way. One day, the child's curiosity grew too strong to ignore, so he pushed through the grass, eager to explore. Lost without his parents, no guiding light, in a sea of green, no direction in sight. He cried and cried, his wails filled the air, and his parents found him, standing in despair. Staff, students, and executives, I'm sorry for cutting the story short and leaving things with more questions than answers, but let me ask you this. If you were the child who ventured through the wild, would you be inspired to continue towards the bay? Or would you rather retreat back to where you came from? It's easy to let curiosity, ambition, and passion run wild, but what happens when you're driven solely by these? Like the child, you might feel lost or scared having lost your light. In his case, his parents. Whether it's your parents, a mentor, or something else entirely, everyone needs that guiding light. Without it, we're left with no sense of direction, our perspectives mimicking a tunnel. Some say, do what's right for you, but I'd like to add to that. Perspective is crucial. When you see someone for the first time, you make assumptions based on how they appear, speak, and behave. You make a complete personality profile for a person you merely glimpsed across the street without even knowing if it's accurate. But is that really the way things should be? We always hear, oh, you like this kind of thing, so you must be this type of person, which is often a gross generalization and that hinders our understanding and growth. The simplicity of assuming interrupts the intricacy of each person. From such a brief glance, people think they know what's going on the inside. They don't. No one does. So why is it that we judge others by their exterior, but we judge ourselves by our interior? If assumption-based socializing is inherently flawed, what do you think it does to someone who's been internally gnawed by society's teeth? It's selfish to rely solely on assumptions and lack open-mindedness. Similarly, we all know goals, dreams, and aspirations change, sometimes sporadically, sometimes gradually. The core reason these components change is because we ourselves have changed too. As perspectives shift, so do ambitions. It's easy to look back at our own past and laugh or cringe, but why do we feel so much more critical when we look at others in retrospect? Why is it that our judgments of others are harsher while we allow ourselves the grace to grow and change? Everyone's perspective evolves given time, not just yours. Give others the leniency that you give yourself. So, the next time someone has an opposition in a proposition, find a balance to your reactance. Reflect how you might have been in their shoes once too. Back to the child. Why did the parents heed the way? Well, there was no bay to fear, just lessons to learn along the way. The child's perspective grew from experience, just like every challenge we face. I know, it's an anticlimactic ending to the totally invigorating story. But a view we once held so dear can in a moment be changed crystal clear, like a switch flipped with ease or a shift in the breeze. Then why do we look at others' perspectives so wearily? To each their own, a truth be embraced. Far more than we shall ever know lies in each face. Seeing eye to eye isn't always right. Instead, look ahead, look at your previous sight. When you had a different view, and now you have a new, everyone grows, shifts their frame, blame not others, for they do the same. My name is Zaid Kaji. Remember, understanding others' true perspectives begins with recognizing your own growth. Those were my last words.